The new satellite is optimized for urban operations. Its modular design allows it to be stored in a backpack and be reassembled within minutes. With an operation range of 3,000 feet and a maximum altitude of 1,000 feet, this UAV is more than equipped to support a wide range of applications autonomously. Providing command and control of this unmanned system is the Ground Command Control Station, GCCS. The interface is shown here on the main panel as well as the side monitors around the arena. The GCCS is designed to be generic, scalable, and portable, allowing easy integration to different types of unmanned platforms. If I could draw your attention to the right-hand side of the main panel and side monitors, you can see real-time images captured by the UAVs. For this demonstration, targets in the arena have been marked with an X to represent drop-off points for medical and food supplies. These targets are identified by the UAVs and their location sent to the UGV. Multiple UAVs are able to operate the same area autonomously, coordinating and collaborating with each other to maximize the search coverage area of the disaster site. The decentralized nature of this collaboration allows continuous operations even in areas with weak communication links. This also ensures that the systems is scalable to an even larger fleet of unmanned platforms. As the UAVs scan the disaster site, the images are pieced together, frame by frame, to create a full aerial view of the site. This is commonly known as video mosaic. The UAVs have completed their survey missions. The generated aerial photograph can now be used to aid rescue mission planning. Meanwhile, the UAVs will continue to survey the site. UGVs can be operated autonomously or be remote controlled when required. They are best used in applications where normal access by humans could be dangerous or impossible. The UGV is now being deployed to deliver supplies for trapped victims, buying valuable times for rescue teams to plan and prepare for their rescue missions. It also serves as an observation post for rescue teams to understand the terrain before moving in. Depending on the mission objective, both the UAVs and the UGV can equip with customized payloads to further enhance their capabilities. Installed in the unmanned systems today is the HexMat payload capability, which allows hazardous materials to be detected. In addition, the SearchMat is also used to detect mobile phone signals, which can indicate the positions of people buried under rubble. Results from the HexMat and SearchMat are displayed here on the top right-hand corner of the GCCS main panel and side monitors. The rescue plan is now ready for execution, and human rescue teams are deployed. All unmanned systems are recalled to base, ready for the next mission. I hope you have enjoyed the demonstration that ST Engineering, in collaboration with Nanyang Technological University, have presented. Thank you for your time, and we wish you a fun and fulfilling day at the Singapore Airshow 2016. kindly please proceed to the Smart City Cluster for the next presentation. Thank you.